Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Okay. White lie. White lie. Who among you have told even once in your lifetime a white lie? Who among you have told even once in your lifetime a white lie? Sino na sa inyo ang nakapagsabi ng isang white lie? Aminin. For sure, most of us, if not all, but I doubt, no, na hindi tayo lahat, no, had told a white lie. But what is a white lie? Well, simply, it is a lie that we tell to avoid hurting people or to avoid any conflict or to save one's face. But is it justifiable? Okay lang ba ang white lie? Yung tipo bang tatanungin ka, masarap bang luto ko? Bagay ba yung damit ko? Okay na ba yung sayaw ko? Ay, oo naman, ikaw naman. Father, ayaw ko lang naman po kasing may masaktan, kaya nasabi ko po yun. Ayaw ko lang po may magalit, Father. Ayaw ko lang naman po may mapahamak, kaya nasabi ko po yun. Well, dear friends, in lying, there is no such thing as black or white. White lie is still a lie. It is still not the truth. In our gospel today, some Pharisees and Herodians were sent to catch Jesus in his words, to catch and even trap him whether he will answer something erratic or wrong. And according to them, based on their introduction to Jesus, Jesus is a truthful man. Jesus is a truthful man, not concerned with anyone's opinion, regardless of the person's status, and teaches the way of God in accordance with the truth. Well, they really spoke well of Jesus. All of this are true. With this, we can all deduce one important characteristic of a truthful man. And what is it? He will always tell the truth regardless of others' reaction or possible setback to him. He will always tell the truth regardless of others' reaction or possible setback to him. And we all saw this in Jesus' life. No, where he will always proclaim the truth regardless of the possible reaction from others. Masaktan man sila, magalit man sila, sasabihin pa rin Jesus kung ano yung totoo. And even if he can be killed because of it, alam naman natin, nababasa naman natin na si Jesus, dahil sa kanyang pagsasabi ng totoo, maraming gustong patayin siya. Well, dear friends, truth is always absolute. And it should not depend on others' possible reaction or consequence. And if we remain in the truth, even if we are put into the test like Jesus, we will remain blameless. We will remain blameless. And as followers of Jesus, who is truth himself, we are always called to be instrument of the truth. Magsabi ng totoo kahit ano ang mangyari. Well, dear friends, as what the famous expression would say, always tell the truth and nothing but the truth. Amen.